So let us discuss static friction in detail. We are on static friction now. Static friction. Static friction, it is a self-adjusting force. Static friction is a self-adjusting force. This is also a very important point. Static friction is a self-adjusting force. Static friction adjusts itself according to the value of applied force. We'll discuss this in detail by giving an example just after a few minutes. Static limiting friction is maximum value of static friction. Maximum value of static friction. So static friction adjusts its value according to the applied force. When I applied a force of 10 Newton, static friction becomes equal to 10 Newton. When I apply a force of 20 Newton, static friction may become equal to 20 Newton. When I apply 25 Newton, static friction may become 25. However, there is also an upper limit value of static friction that is called static limiting friction. Say for example, static limiting friction for a block is 50 Newton. So when I apply a force greater than 50 Newton, block will start moving. Static friction cannot make its value greater than static limiting friction. It is the maximum value of static friction. So a block does not move till the applied force is less than the value of static limiting friction. Third point is block does not move till applied force is less than static limiting friction. Body does not move till applied force is less than static limiting friction. Again, and what if applied force is greater than static limiting friction? When applied force is greater than static limiting friction, body starts moving. When applied force is greater than maximum value of static friction, body starts moving. And we have studied that when body starts moving, then the friction that acts is called kinetic friction. So important point, this was for kinetic friction. When body starts moving, kinetic friction starts acting. So now we also have some other points based on static limiting friction. These are called laws of limiting friction. Laws of limiting friction, static limiting friction. Laws of limiting friction. Suppose there is a block lying on a horizontal platform. Weight is mg. Normal direction is acting upwards. I'm applying some force on the block. Suppose static limiting friction, maximum value of static friction is in backward direction that we will study. That static limiting friction is always opposite to the direction in which body is on the verge of moving. Right, I am applying some force. If the force will exceed the value of static limiting friction, block will start moving towards right. So direction of static limiting friction is towards left. So the law is direction of limiting friction is always opposite to the direction in which body is on the verge of moving. Right? Verge of moving is just about to move. Right? Second very important thing is that static limiting friction is directly proportional to the normal reaction. When you remove the proportionality sign, we add a constant mu s. Mu s is coefficient of static friction. This is coefficient of static friction. It depends on nature of surfaces in contact. Mu s depends on nature of surfaces in contact. So let us elaborate the point, very important point, that its static limiting friction is mu s multiplied by normal reaction. This is a very, very important point. So friction is a self-adjusting force. It adjusts itself equal to the value of applied force till the applied force is less than the maximum value of static friction, that is static limiting friction. When the applied force exceeds the value of static limiting friction, then block will start moving, and when the block will start moving, then kinetic friction will definitely start acting. Direction of static limiting friction is opposite to the direction in which block was on the verge of moving, and magnitude of static limiting friction is directly proportional to the normal reaction. Right? So let us deal with some examples based on Fs max is mu s into n. So here I'll clear a misconception that friction is not mu mg. Friction is mu multiplied by normal reaction. It is not mu mg. So let us have examples on friction. Well, let us calculate the value of friction for various cases. Static limiting friction equals to mu s multiplied by normal reaction. So let us discuss some examples. We have case 1. Block is lying on a horizontal surface. Mg is acting downwards. Okay. Normal reaction is acting upwards. I'm applying some force on the block. This is an external force. Static friction is acting in the direction opposite to the direction in which body is on the verge of moving. Body is about to move towards right. Say it is about to move towards right. Friction will act in the towards left. So static limiting friction equals to mu s multiplied by normal reaction. In this case, normal reaction is mg. So this becomes mu s mg. So value of static limiting friction is mu s mg till applied force is less than or equal to mu s mg. Mu s mg in this case, block remains at rest. Till applied force is less than mu s mg, block remains at rest. And when applied force is greater than mu s mg, block starts sliding definitely. So if the normal reaction gets changed, value of friction gets changed. Value of static limiting friction gets changed. So let us have another example, case 2. Block lying on inclined plane. Obviously, normal reaction will not be mg in this case, so static limiting friction will not be mu mg in this case, right? Block of mass m is lying on inclined plane, mg downwards. This component is mg cos theta. This is mg sin theta. Next, we have normal reaction here. Normal reaction is equal to mg cos theta. Suppose block is on the verge of sliding towards down, static limiting friction is acting in upward direction. Value of static limiting friction is mu s multiplied by normal reaction. This is actually mu s times mg cos theta. So value of static limiting friction is not mu s mg, it is mu s mg cos theta. Let us take some another example. We have some examples of pulling and pushing a block. See, case 3, pulling a block, pulling of block, right? Block of mass M is lying on a horizontal surface. Block of mass M is lying on a horizontal surface. We apply capital F force, which is called a pulling force. Direction is basically a pulling force. Coefficient of static friction is mu s, right? Component of force capital F is F cos theta. Another component is F sin theta. Mg is acting downwards. So Mg is acting downwards. Now, coefficient of static friction is mu s. Normal reaction in the upward direction. For equilibrium, friction will act in the backward direction. Body is on the verge of moving, say on the verge of moving towards right. F cos theta is trying to move the block towards right. For equilibrium of the block along y direction, summation Fy must be zero. That means normal reaction and F sin theta together balance Mg. So normal reaction becomes equal to Mg minus F sin theta, right? Static limiting friction here is mu s times normal reaction, which is not mu s mg, which is mu s mg minus f sin theta. Another question. So friction, value of friction is not mu s mg, mind it, my dear students. It is mu times normal reaction. Mu times normal reaction. If the value of normal reaction is different for a different question, then certainly friction is different. Let us take another example of, say, pushing a block. This was example of pulling the block. Let us take the example of pushing the block. So we are applying some force capital F in order to push the block. This angle is theta. Weight of the block is acting downwards. Mg is downward, right? So normal reaction is upwards. Let us resolve the value of forces. This is F cos theta. And this is actually F sin theta, right? Block is on the verge of sliding towards left. Static limiting friction will act towards right. Summation Fy. Let us discuss the equilibrium of block along y-axis. Block is not moving along y-axis, it is sliding along x-axis. Summation Fy must be zero. N is balanced by F sin theta plus Mg. Static limiting friction equals to mu times normal reaction. This is mu s multiplied by F sin theta plus Mg. This is the value of static limiting friction. So this is the value of static limiting friction for pulling a block. This is the value of static limiting friction for pushing the block with the same force. Value of friction is less for pulling the block. So it is easier to pull a block. It is easier to pull a block than to push it. It is always easier to pull a block than to push it. Okay. So let us discuss some another case in which normal reaction will not involve even Mg. But there will be no Mg in the normal reaction. So Fifth case, case 5. Block is kept horizontal, is kept intact on a rough wall by applying some force capital F against the wall. So, what is the value of static limiting friction? Block has a tendency to slide downwards. Block certainly has a tendency to slide downward. Static limiting friction has to act in the upward direction. Fs max. So, normal reaction provided by the wall will be equal and opposite to capital F. So here normal reaction equals to F. Static limiting friction is not mu s mg here, it is mu s into normal reaction, which is mu s times capital F. So the external applied force may also decide static limiting friction. There is no component of mg. There is no role of mg in deciding the static limiting friction in this case. So the important and the only important point which I want to convey through these five examples was that static limiting friction is mu times normal reaction. It is not mu mg, right? Kindly note down, dear students. Let us move on to another law of limiting friction. So far we have discussed two laws of limiting friction. One was that static limiting friction is always opposite to the direction in which body is on the verge of moving. And another thing, very important thing, was that static limiting friction is directly proportional to the normal reaction. Okay. Third law says, laws of limiting friction continued. Laws of limiting friction continued. We have discussed with the first law, we have discussed with the second law. Third one we have, obviously the magnitude of static limiting friction depends on nature of surfaces in contact, whether they are smooth, whether they are rough, whether they are very rough. So static limiting friction depends on nature of surfaces in contact. This was static limiting friction is directly proportional to normal reaction. This was opposite to direction in which body is on the verge of moving, and so on, right? Static limiting friction depends on nature of surfaces in contact. And the fourth is, if you place a block horizontally, mg downwards, you apply some force on it, and you place a block vertically, mg downwards, you apply force capital F, right? So normal reaction is same for both the cases. Nature of surfaces is same for both the cases. So static limiting friction will be same for both the cases. So in all, I want to say that value of static limiting friction is independent of apparent area of contact. It is independent of area of contact, apparent area of contact. Whether the block is placed horizontally, sidewise, or lengthwise, value of static limiting friction will be same for both the cases. So Fs max does not depend on apparent area of contact. Why they have written apparent area of contact? Because what we think is the area of contact is not actually the area of contact. There are some irregularities in the block and the surface. So actual area of contact is much less than what we think is the area of contact, right? This is called apparent area of contact. Static limiting friction does not depend on apparent area of contact. So these were the four laws of limiting friction. Let us discuss the points which I had written earlier, that static limiting friction is a self-adjusting force. Block does not move till applied force is less than static limiting friction. When the applied force exceeds static limiting friction, block starts moving, and when it starts moving, kinetic friction starts acting. So let us discuss that.